Peace of Christ to everyone. This is the description of Islamic Paradise number two. And I want people to listen carefully because in here we are trying to analyze and to study the one who wrote the Quran, how he is trying to convince you to accept Islam. Because the reward is what Muslims are looking for. Like everything they do for what? For the reward. From understanding the reward of Islam, we will understand what Islam is about. So now we will listen to an Islamic scholar as the first part. He will continue reading for us from his Quran, and we will see what the God of Islam is talking about, and we will help you to understand more about this God. Let us go.
Of silver, but yet they are crystal clear, and they will be given to them, and they will have the measure of whatever they wish to have.
Okay, we will stop in here. You know, if you go and listen to the first one, you will see that the God is promising them clothes of silk, couches, air conditioning. You will sit in the shade and you will not feel the heat or the cold. Then now he is saying the measure of whatever you wish. Guys, do you know how extremely bad this promise? When God, he said to me, I will give you the measure of whatever you wish. When God, he said to you, whatever you wish, it's mean whatever you wish, correct?
Made of silver, but yet they are crystal clear. And they will be given to them. And they will have the measure of whatever they wish to have.
Okay. Now, let us say, I am a Muslim, I went to the heaven of Islam, and Allah, he is promising me to have whatever I wish, and I did wish to have the wife of Muhammad in my bed. Can Allah say no? You are saying to me, you just promise Allah, that whatever, when you say whatever, it's mean whatever. When you say whatever you wish to have, the measure of whatever, like you know what? Use your imagination. And whatever it's mean, whatever too. Like, if a man, he went to the heaven of Islam, and he want to sleep with Muhammad himself, he want to do bang bang to Muhammad, he's a gay. You just promise him that you will have the measure of whatever you wish. If we ask Muhammad, is it true that your God, he said, whatever I wish to have, you will have. He will say yes. Then if I say to him, what if there is somebody is going to bang you? You know, he wished to bang you. For some reason, maybe because he loves you too much. You know, he's a gay and he loves you too much. Is your God Allah going to do his wish? Muhammad cannot say no. Because the Quran says, whatever you wish. What if I go to heaven of Allah and I wish to have all Muslim women in my bed, in the world? And you know, this is unlimited, we can make unlimited wishes, and this is will prove to us that this God is a big filthy liar. Because you cannot make these wishes for everyone. What if the same man, he wished the same woman, and there is another million men, they wish to have the same woman? What he will do? How they can have her all? Are we getting the point? So this God is just trying to fool you, saying to you, whatever you wish to have. But the fact, think about it. Can somebody say to you, whatever you wish to have? Even if he's God. Even if he's God. Because as long my wish, it can be a woman, and this woman is only one. What God will do? The only way maybe he will create, he will make a copy? It's not going to work. Because I want the one, that woman, each one of us, let us say we are 100 men, we want to have one woman, and we don't want copy, because you promise us to have whatever we wish. We want that woman. Not a copy. Copy is a copy. I want that woman. Any other copy is not going to be that woman anymore. It's just a copy. So in here, we will see that this God, or the, whoever made this Quran, you know, he is just fooling those Bedouin people who have no idea how to think about it. Like, you know, they are poor people, they have no education. You know, we are talking about a Muslim who believed that Muhammad, he fly to Allah with a donkey have two wings. We are talking about a Muslim who believed that the King Salman or the Prophet Salman, he fly from Damascus all the way to Yemen in the top of a flying carpet, and there's more than 1 million human being and animal and donkey and horses and soldier, etc., in the top of that flying carpet. This is what we are talking about. Those are the people we are talking to. And this is, will show you that those people, when we say they are brainwashed, this is a very wrong word to say. A Muslim man is not a brainwashed. He have no brain, because you cannot believe in this and you have a brain. Washing what? If you have a brain, you have a brain. You cannot wash a brain. So when your God says to you, I will give you whatever you wish to have, ask yourself a very simple question. What if many of us have the same wish? Wish to have the same woman. And even, what if a woman, a Muslim woman, wish to have 2 million men in her bed to have sex with them? You just say whatever you wish. And a Muslim woman is a Muslim too. But the fact, all of us, we knew that a Muslim woman, she will never have any wish. Because she herself is a wish of someone. And I challenge any Muslim to show me that she can wish whatever she want to wish. From here we will understand that this God is saying words he don't mean, because he is a liar. And you know what? Come and work for me. And build my house. And die for me. And when you die, one day I will give you 1 million mountain of gold. This is what Allah is saying. When you die, I will give you a lot of women for sex. I will give you money and honey and milk. But now he can give nothing. Let us continue.
They will have to the measure of whatever they wish to have. وَيُسْقَوْنَ فِيهَا كَأْسًا كَانَ مِزَاجُهَا زَنْجَبِيلًا. And in the Jannah they will be given a cup of wine. Not the wine that makes you intoxicated. A cup of wine. Wine that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made as a reward for the people of the Jannah. They will be given a cup of wine, and mixed in it is zanjabil.
Wait. Guys, Allah is promoting his whiskey. Because he knew that those are Bedouin people, they love to drink. So you know what? You know, it doesn't make sense to invite them to paradise, have women, have food, have milk, have honey. There is something missing. What is missing? The wine. They love wine. And look at him. He's saying, by the way, the Quran never say if they are going to be drunk or not. And you know what? Wine is a wine. It means there is alcohol. Because if there is no alcohol, it's not going to be a wine anymore. And if this wine is a wine, you know, if I'm getting drunk or not, it's not going to make a difference. It's a wine. So Allah is saying to me, I will give you the ability to drink as much as you want, but you will not get drunk. But still, it's a wine. And the Quran says in one of the verses that the wine is one of the dirt of Satan, is the maid of Satan. So Allah will buy the maid of Satan, the product of Satan, and put it in the paradise of Allah. As you see, this is Surah 5, verse number 90, and the translation is kind of funny, because in Arabic it says, Innamal Khamru, which means the wine, is the maid, and gambling, etc., is made of Satan. So Allah is going to buy the maid of Satan, import it to the heaven of Allah, but all what he will do, he will make you not to be drunk. So this is the heaven of Islam, showing us that this guy who is making this heaven is just trying to fool those people and giving them promises. All of it is full of garbage. Wine, women, etc. Let us continue. Here we go.
A spring that is flowing in the Jannah is named Salsabila.
Wait. You know, this video will not be enough actually for this. You know, so we will continue in the coming video because the coming topic is very important and I don't want to make it at the end of the video. So guys, sorry that we are going slow studying verse by verse, but it's better to study slow and understand than going fast and getting nothing out of it. Follow with me with the coming video. Jesus is Lord. Islam is false. Ameen. Thank you.